Hello everyone, welcome back. Yesterday I started topic tenses. In that I completed simple present tense and present continuous tense. Today I'm starting with present perfect tense. Here we have present perfect tense. The present perfect tense refers to an action or event that started at some time in the past, was completed not much before the time of speaking, and the impact of which is retained at the time of speaking. So what's there? The work which has just been completed, which has just finished. They have visited Singapore recently. Have visited shows, sentence is in present perfect tense. Now the structure of present perfect tense, structure of verb in present perfect tense is use of has or have. With that, you have to use third form of verb. And third form of verb, we call it past participle. Again, repeating, use of has or have according to the subject. With that, past participle. Or you can say third form of verb. I have been to Kathmandu once. They have finished their preparation for the exams. Just completed this work. So here you have, because you have subject plural there. With that third form of verb, this is past participle of finish. So this is present perfect tense. If subject is plural, I or you, there you have to use have. If the subject is singular, there you have to use has. One minute. Yeah. Using the present perfect tense. Let's see where we can use present perfect tense. The present perfect tense is used to refer to, first point, a completed action in the past that has some relevance in or connection with the present here. It's not written there. I have known you since my childhood. That means at past time, this was there and still he knows it. So here we have and third form of know, have known. See the second one, an indefinite action in the past where the exact time and other details are not given. Have you been to this place before? No exact time is given there. No other details of the past time is mentioned there. No specific time in the past. The action is emphasized more than anything else. So in that condition, when no time of past is given there, there you can use present perfect tense. So you have with that been. See this next one. An action that got over just before the time of speaking. Before the time of speaking, that work got completed, just finished. There you can use present perfect tense. Prerna has just broken the vase. So this work just completed. So you has, because Prerna, singular subject there, has. With that, broken, third form of break. Next one, in news, you have to use present perfect tense in news headline, simple present. The financial budget has allocated funds for rural housing. So it's a news, so we have has allocated, present perfect tense. Next one, a repeated action that continues till the present time. See this example. She has practiced her role several times before this. So this is an action, practicing, that she was doing at the past time and till the present time it was done. So there has practiced. We have present perfect tense. A mental action in progress that started in the past and has continued. Something started in the past, especially mental action, and still it is going on. He has always enjoyed his responsibility as the class captain. That means that he enjoyed in the past when he was given the responsibility, and still he enjoys that. So there we have, he has, this is the contraction of he has, and enjoyed, third form of verb, right? Now, after this, you have one exercise related to this. Complete the sentence below using the words in the brackets in their present perfect form. So you have to use present perfect tense. First is written there. I haven't seen, in bracket, you have not seen. So present perfect is haven't seen the movie, The Half-Blood Prince yet. This next one, my neighbor Ria and I. Now your word is know each other since 1994. My neighbor Ria and I have known each other. Third one, Gina's aunt is a famous filmmaker. She has made. She is singular. So we have has, and third form of make, made. So your answer is she has made 5 films till now. Next one. She dashed the best film award for one of her films. So here, present perfect of receive. She has received the best film award for one of our films. Sentence number E. I dash 5 letters to you, but you have replied to none. Your answer is I. With I, we write have. So I have. And third form of write is written. So your answer is I have written 5 letters to you, but you have replied to none. Now sentence number F. Your daughter dashed so tall in the last 2 years. Now your daughter, singular subject, sorry, has, third form of grow is grown. Your daughter has grown so tall in the last 3 years. Next sentence. I dash Sheena in a long time. Words given in the bracket is not see. And present perfect of this, with I will write have not seen, third form of see. Your answer is, I have not seen Sheena in a long time. Next sentence. I heard that she dashed very well in her final examinations. I heard that she is singular subject, so we'll use has, she has. Third form of do is done. She has done very well in her final examinations. So that was the exercise. Now, this is structure of the present perfect tense in different sentences. First, we have affirmative. Yeah. Subject, third person given, he, she, singular, subject Reena given there. So in this condition, if you have third person as subject or singular subject there, you have to use has. This is auxiliary verb. Has and have, these are auxiliary verbs. With that, you have to use main verb, and that is third form of verb. Here it's written worked. So your sentence is, he has worked. If subject you have plural, we, they, the men, these are plural. With that, I and you, I singular, you can be singular or plural. With them, you have to use have. And with that, third form of verb, that is worked. So your sentence, I have worked, or we have worked. Now, negative sentence. Yeah. Subject, he, she, Reena, again, singular subject there. With that, has not, this is the contraction of has not, hasn't. And with that, main verb, worked. He hasn't worked. Now, if you have subject plural or I or you, in that condition, have not, or you can say haven't worked. I haven't worked, we have not worked, you haven't worked. This is your negative sentence. Now, interrogative. We have WH word here. With that, auxiliary verb, has or have. Then you have to write subject. What has he or she read? This is third form of read. Spelling is same, but we pronounce it as read. What have, with that, I read, or what have we read, or what have they read? This is interrogative. If you have to make another without WH word, then you have to write, have you read this book? This is another interrogative form. Okay. So that was your present perfect tense. Now, let's see this present perfect continuous tense. The present perfect continuous tense refers to an action or event or condition that started in the past and is going on till the time of speaking. Sentences in the present perfect continuous usually carry an indication of the duration, such as for 20 minutes, for 2 hours, since last month, and so on. Okay. Now, In this, the condition is the work in the sentence started at some past time, and that work is still going on in the present time, right? In that condition, you have to use present perfect continuous tense. Now, with that, one more thing there, duration of time is given. Like it's given there for 20 minutes, for 2 hours, this is duration of time given. So you'll find these things there, use of for or since. Understood? Let's see these examples. Amit has been studying since 5 a.m. That means he started at 5 a.m. and still he is doing that work. So in that condition, you have to use this structure. Now the structure of present perfect continuous is use of has or have according to the subject. With that, been you have to use, and with that ing form of verb, or we call it present participle. So has been studying, this is present perfect continuous tense. With that, this duration of time is also given there, that is since 5 a.m. Next one. I have been waiting for you for the last 2 hours. That means started last 2 hours and still he is doing that work of waiting. So in that condition, you have the structure of present perfect continuous, have been waiting, and in this sentence you have this time duration for the last 2 hours. Next one. They have been working for the company since it was established. That means they started that time when it was established and still they are working there. So in that condition you have this have been working. This shows sentence is in present perfect continuous tense. And this is time given there, duration of time, since it was established. No fixed time given there, but this shows the time only. Notice that all the sentences above refer to actions that started in the past and are continuing without interruption till the present time. Started at some past time, you can see in these examples, and still it's in continuation. They also refer to a specific duration or a starting point of the action. Some duration of time is given there, or the point of time when the work was started. Now we move on to the other part. With this example again. Amit has been studying since 5 a.m. That means at this time, this is past time, 5 a.m., he started, and that work is in continuation till this time of speaking. So in that condition, present perfect continuous, your structure is has been studying here. Okay. Now, using the present perfect continuous tense, where we can use. The present perfect continuous tense is used when we want to emphasize the duration of an action or event that has already begun in the past and is going on at the time of speaking. Putting emphasis or force on the time or the duration of the action. The work was started at some past time and still going on. See this example. The teacher has been speaking to the students for the last 2 hours. This time period is given there for the last 2 hours. That means he started before these 2 hours and still she's speaking. So has been speaking here. See this next example. The teacher is speaking to the students. Now no time duration is given there. Action is in progress. And so we have is speaking. This is present continuous tense. Okay. In this, you have for the last 2 hours, so we have here has been speaking. And here, nothing is mentioned there that work is going on at the time of speaking, only this thing there. So we have present continuous tense is speaking. Next one. A reference is made to an action that ended just before the time of speaking. Sometimes we use this thing. That work which started at some past time, but just before the time of speaking, it got over. The nation has been keeping a close watch over the election result. That means they were doing this work in the time of speaking, but they finished that thing just before the time of speaking. This means the results are out and therefore the watch has ended. So in that condition, you have has been keeping. This is present perfect continuous form. Now, next we have use of since and for. You have seen in these sentences, we are writing duration of time using since or for. Now, where we have to use since and where for. Since is used to refer to the time of the beginning of an action. It shows at what time the action started. I have been writing an article since 12 noon. This is point of time. Some exact time is given there. That is point of time. And there we use since. I'm writing an article since 12 noon. That means that is the starting of the action, started at 12 and still going on. So we have present perfect continuous here. Now use of for. For is used to denote the duration of an action. I have been writing an article for 8 hours. This is period of time given there. Duration of an action for 8 hours is period of time. That means from 12 to 8, that is 8 hours, period of time. And here since 12 noon, this is point of time. So with period of time, you have to use for. And if point of time is given there, you have to use since. Okay. Now, next thing. Structure of present perfect continuous tense. Affirmative sentence. In that, what is the structure? Let's see. Subject, if you have third person, he or she, or singular subject there, like Rina, which is, it's written there. With that, auxiliary verb has or have, but with third person and singular subject, you have to use has. With that, you have to write been. And main verb is present participle. That is, which is given here is studying, ing form of verb. So he has been studying. Now with plural subject or I or you, you have to write have, with that, been, and studying. So your sentence is I have been studying or you have been studying. See this negative one now. With singular subject, he hasn't or has not been, then main verb is studying. Or she has not been studying. Now, if you have plural subject or I or you there. With that, you have to use haven't or have not. I have not been studying. We haven't been studying. They haven't been studying. Or the men have not been studying. This is the negative form or the structure of present perfect continuous in negative sentences. Now, next one, interrogative, using WH word or WH question. Here we are using what. Now, with that, what has, subject will be singular. Has, you have to write first, then subject, as he, she, or Rina, anything, then been, and with that, main verb, studying. So this is interrogative. What has he been studying? If plural subject, what have they been studying, or what have I been studying? Next one, what has he been studying? What have you been studying? Now, if it is negative in interrogative, then what hasn't he been studying, or what hasn't she been studying? With has, you have to write not. If plural subject or I there or you there, then what haven't or have not I been studying, or what have not you been studying, or they been studying. So that was the structure of present perfect continuous in different types of sentences, that is affirmative, negative, and interrogative. Now let's see this exercise. Okay, fill in the blanks with the present continuous and the present perfect continuous tense of the verbs given in brackets. We have to use both present continuous or present perfect continuous. Let's see, first is done here. I have been writing this book for the last 1 year. This time of action or duration of action is given for the last 1 year. So here we have been writing, present perfect continuous. See the second sentence. I dash to submit it by the end of this month. So I am going to submit it by the end of this month. Am going. This is present continuous. Next one. Sarita dash from flew. No sense for given there. No duration of time given there. So here we have to use present continuous. Sarita is suffering from flu. She dashed to school since last Monday. Since last Monday is given there. So here we have to use present perfect continuous, that is, she has not been coming to school since last Monday. See this next one. Halima dash to catch up with the mathematics problem. No duration of time given there or duration of action given there. So we'll use present continuous. That means at the time of speaking, the action is going on. So your answer is Halima is trying to catch up with the mathematics problem. Our teacher dash her every day after class since last month. Now, since last month is given there, that means the last month, the teacher is doing that action and still going on. So here, what will you write? Our teacher has been helping. Present perfect continuous. Has been helping her every day after class since last month. Now, next sentence. I dash here for the last 1 hour. Now here, he started this work 1 hour before and still going on. And or you can say this time duration is given there. So here we'll use present perfect continuous. So your answer is, I have been waiting here for the last 1 hour. But nobody dash any attention to me. So here we'll use present continuous tense. But nobody is paying any attention to me. Right? See this next one. Palani dash French these days. Word is learn. Now, here, that action is going on at the time of speaking and no sense of war given there. So we'll use Palani is learning. Present continuous, Palani is learning French these days. Okay, so that was the exercise related to present continuous and present perfect continuous. I hope you have understood the difference between these two. So that's all for today. Tomorrow I'll be back with past tense. Okay. So thank you all. See you tomorrow. Goodbye.